We are looking at let us see solutions. This is chapter 4, the case control structure. Question on switch case control. First is, what is the output? This is switch is 3. So 3 will come and there is no 3, only 1 and 2. So this will be printed hard. And after that, when the switch completes, this print will be I thought 1 wears a sweet. So heart and I thought 1 wears sweet will come. Next is K, J is equal to 2. So that is K is equal to J plus 1. So K will be equal to J, that is 2 plus 1. That will be K will be 3. So this 3 will be matched, but there is no 3. There is no 3. So this has to come. Pure simple egg head. It will go to default. Then I equal to 0. So 0 is going to match with this one. But since there is no break, it will go to case 1 also, case 2, case 3. So all these 4 will be printed because there is no break. That is why. Character is A. When you match this character, if it matches A, it matches A. After that, it will go to B also. And it will print you entered B. But there is no break. So it will go to A also. So both of these printing will be done. Both will be printed. This char I equal to 1, and this 1 means when you place inside 1 inside your single quotes, it will be what? It will be the ASCII value of this symbol, or you can say this digit 1. It is not going to match with either of 0 or 1 or 2, so it will go to the default just to survive. What is the error in this program? The error is, see carefully, please observe, there is a semicolon. There is no semicolon in switch. After parenthesis, there is no semicolon. This is a wrong syntax. Then here, we are taking something in temp and we are trying to match this temp with these relational expressions. These are not allowed. These relational expressions are not allowed. So the relational operators cannot be used in cases. A is 3.5. A. I'll stop here only. Why? Because this switch, inside this parenthesis, we cannot have anything other than integer or character. So this is not acceptable. Floats cannot be used in cases. Only integer, only this will only be integer expression or integer constant. Write a menu driven program for the following option: factorial of a number, prime or not, odd or even, exit. So when the user will be provided this, or when the program will run, user will be provided with this menu. He is going to choose any of them, and depending upon his choice, these operations needs to be done. If he presses 4, it needs to, your program needs to be stop, or you should come out of the menu. So first we'll write just without writing the content. How to write? This is a menu driven program. So we enter it in a choice, and we see this is while 1 means this is an infinite loop. This is an infinite loop, that is indefinite loop, infinite. Okay. So because we have a choice exit, so we can go ahead with the indefinite. So this will be printed first of all like this. Printing of these 4 will be done, and then we'll take the user choice after this 4. This user choice will be taken in this choice, and after that choice, we'll match it with case 1, case 2, case 3, and 4. So when user presses 1, we'll find out the factorial. Then if 2, then prime number, 3, odd, even. Otherwise, we exit. Now let us see the program with these codes: factorial, prime number, and odd, even. But before that, this while 1 is actually showing you the indefinite loop, because we have exit, so we can just come home. Exit is standard library function, and exit, because break only takes you out of an innermost loop. If you want to come out of the program, you want to close the program, you have to use this exit. This is a menu driven program, same program with now the code for factorial, prime, and odd also. So this is menu driven program. We start with stdio.h and conio.h. Then we enter the choice number I, and this is the fact. So we'll take 1, that is we want to take it to the infinite loop till the time user don't press 4. Otherwise this will go on and on and on. So this is the choice. We'll use the choice being given by user as the input to our switch. Now, depending upon the choice, if the choice is 1, we'll try to find out the factorial. Factorial, you know, we have already learned that, but still the code is there. We'll enter the number, we'll start with fact equal to 1, and till the time 1 reaches that number, we'll try to find out fact equal to fact into I, and we'll print the fact, and then we'll break. Then if a user presses 2, then we'll enter the number, we'll try to go from 2 to n minus 1, that is 2 to n minus 1, that is if the user enters n, we'll take all the number from 2 to n minus 1 and try to divide n by any of these numbers, I mean all of these numbers actually. If this n divides by any of these numbers, then we say n is not a prime, otherwise n is a prime. So we start with 2, we go up to num minus 1, and we divide all these I with n, num. And if at all any of them divides it fully, we say it is not a prime number, and we break. Otherwise, if this doesn't happen, then I will remain as, because I will reach num. And if I reaches that number without any number before that, possibly not able to define or divide the number, then we say, okay, it is actually a prime number. Then we break. Then we press user press 3. We wait for the input. If he enters 3, we enter the number. We divide the number by 2 and find out the modulo, that is the remainder. If the remainder is 0, it is an even number. Otherwise, it is an odd number. Then we break. Now, if the user presses 4, we exit. This is how this program goes. So, this is all about the question answers of case switch case control. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.